guys, so in the comment section last night, somebody linked a video, and the video was about Cannon Hinnant. And if you don't know Cannon Hinnant, he is the 5-year-old boy who was shot and killed point blank by a 25-year-old neighbor while he was outside riding his bike. This happened on Sunday night. And I'm going to get more into that in a second because I'm looking at an article and I have a little bit of information to give you as far as that. But I was looking into this story last night, and a lot of commentators were talking about it, and people are talking about it because there's a lot of anger around this story because it's not getting the media attention that a lot of people feel like it deserves, and I feel like it deserves. I feel like any time a child dies by a gunshot at the hand of an adult, it should be front page everywhere. We should all be outraged, and we should all come together and want justice, and this should be known. But for some reason, because it doesn't fit the narrative right now, you're not going to hear about this like you're going to hear about other things. And this happened Sunday, and I still haven't seen this as much as I see other things. So I was reading up on this last night, and this morning I woke up and I felt very angry. And one of the first things that I saw this morning was an Instagram post by somebody that I follow. And this person lives in, or is from Minneapolis. Sorry, my phone almost died. This person is from Minneapolis, Minnesota, and posted a pic. They went to Minneapolis at the scene where George Floyd was killed, and they took a picture of this huge vigil. And it was sort of like a virtue signal-y type of picture. And it was like, this happened to George Floyd, blah, blah, blah. Say his name, say her name, say that name. Yet this person has been completely silent about all of the children that have died within the past few months. A lot of these kids died in Chicago, and they're killed playing outside in their yard by a gunshot. Innocent kids caught in the crosshairs and are killed. I'm thinking about this, and I want to tell two little quick stories really fast. Please bear with me. I'll get into this in a second. You can fast forward if you don't want to listen to them, but they're really relevant. I used to work for social services, and we were responsible for taking kids out of the home, giving them emergency placement, and putting them somewhere else. And it, you know, the kids that we were taking, they were victims of sexual abuse, physical abuse, trafficking, all that kind of stuff. And we did a lot of really good work, and we had a lot of really good workers that were helping these kids. And I remember when I started this job, this was in Denver, Colorado, I started this job, and one of the things that you have to do while you work there is, when we were on hours and going out and doing community visits or anything like that, we had a special car. It was a state-owned car, and it said City of Denver on it, and then said who we worked for, Social Services, or Denver Human Services, I'm sorry. And I remember when I first started, some of my coworkers were telling me, you know, just be really careful when you're out in the community driving that car because people don't like us. They call us baby snatchers. And I was like, huh? And they're like, yeah, they call us baby snatchers. And I'm thinking in my head, well, that's insane. We're saving kids. How can they think that? And it's because of this. I'm just going to give you a quick example. Because people see a snapshot of something, and because of their ignorance, because they don't know everything that's going on, they make judgments from this snapshot. For instance, what the public might see is, they might see someone from social services going to a home and taking a child with them. And they see the mother, and the mother's like, oh my God, they just took my baby. They just took my baby. What they didn't know, and I've worked with kids who have had this exact thing happen, what they didn't know is that 9-year-old little girl that we were removing from the home, that mother who was crying on the street corner, that mother was pimping that 9-year-old out for drug money so she could continue her drug habit. So that's what was going on behind the surface. But what people just see is someone coming in and taking a child and then driving off. So they form an opinion in their head based off that snapshot when they don't actually know the full story of what's going on. There is another story that came out of the UK, There were some officers, and again, I don't know what their tactics are. I don't know why they were on a commercial flight. That kind of seems wrong to me. But there was a group of officers boarding a commercial flight, and they had detained an illegal immigrant, and they were on that flight to deport the immigrant. And there were a few officers, and they sat down with the man, and the man started screaming, they're trying to take me away from my family. They're trying to take me away from my family, this and that. Blah, 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 blah. So he's screaming, and while he's doing that, the other people on the plane, they basically antagonize the officers to the point where the officers have to get off the plane and remove the person. The person actually ended up staying in that country. I don't know how this story unfolded after that. I don't know if he was deported again. But all these people felt so good about themselves because they stopped this deportation and they saved this poor man. What they didn't know, and this came out later, was that the reason that this man was being deported is because he kidnapped and held a young girl hostage, a 16-year-old girl, kidnapped, held her hostage, and then had him and his friends run they gang-ard her. I'm sorry, I want to be careful about what I say in my videos. But they did this to her, and they terrorized her and held her hostage for hours and let her go. And her legal team had been working for years to get this, to bring justice and get this man out of the country. So again, you have people seeing a snapshot of something, but nobody looks beyond the surface to know what's actually going on. And this is what happens in our media right now. This is what the media knows this, politicians know this. They know that most people aren't gonna look beyond the surface. You can release a little second video, or you can control what news stories get put on the mainstream media. Therefore, you can control what people think, and you can control how they vote, and you can control the narrative that gets to the people. Because most of us, we're not gonna look beyond the surface. We're gonna trust the media. We're not gonna do our own research. So this woman who posted this on her Instagram, she's not a bad woman. She wants good things, but she doesn't look beyond the surface. And the media does this, and they take advantage of it. And that's why it makes me, I was just so angry this morning thinking about that. And that's why we don't hear about people like Cannon. This story is like 3 days old. I haven't seen this on too much mainstream media, if any. We don't hear about Sequoria Turner, the 8-year-old little girl that was killed in Atlanta by a protester who died in her mom's arms on the way to the hospital. They weren't even involved in the protest. These were innocent people trying to turn around and get away from the protest. You'll never hear about them. You'll never hear about all the little babies in Chicago that are being shot on the street, and they're dying in the street. And you know what's really interesting? Everyone wants to say Donald Trump is such a tyrant and he's evil. Do you know who is helping those people in Chicago? Donald Trump with the Project Legend. They went in, they actually confiscated about 300 guns in one weekend. They got 300 guns in one weekend. I believe 160 of those they confiscated, and then they had an event where people could come in and turn in their guns, and that's what happened. They got 300 guns off the streets of Chicago. Donald Trump has done more than them, than any of these social justice people that I know about who are all like Black Lives Matter. Anywho, okay, let's talk about Cannon, because that's who this is about. But that's why you don't hear about this stuff. It makes me angry. He doesn't fit the narrative. Sequoria Turner doesn't fit the narrative. Those babies in Chicago, they don't fit the narrative. So that's why you don't hear about it. This is out of Wilson, North Carolina. I'm gonna read it to you because I don't wanna get anything wrong. Cannon Hennant, a 5-year-old boy tragically shot and killed in North Carolina last weekend, will be memorialized with a funeral Thursday and a candlelight vigil on Friday night. The shooting happened around 5:30 p.m. on Sunday, August 9th. When officers arrived, they found Cannon suffering from a gunshot wound. Officers and EMS immediately began performing life-saving efforts. The boy was taken to the hospital, where he later died. Neighbor Charlene Walborn said another neighbor told her that a man walked up to Cannon and shot him. Our neighbor saw it. She said the young man just walked up to the little boy who was sitting on his bike, which he does every day in his home, in his neighborhood. I just don't understand why he did it. How can you walk up to a little boy point blank and point a gun to his head and just shoot him? How can anyone do that? We were eating our dinner and we heard a bang, this neighbor said. We knew it was a gunshot, so I told my husband to call 911 and I ran to the door. The suspect is a 25-year-old Darius Sessoms, who was arrested the day after the shooting on charges of first degree murder. He's a Black man I don't know if this is why we're not hearing about it. If the roles were reversed, if this was a black kid and a white man, even though we don't know if this is racist. This is just the color of their skin. We can't call it that right now. But if these were reversed, this would be everywhere. We would have rioting breaking out all across the country. I want to read a little bit more. A vigil for Cannon is set for Thursday at 8 p.m. His mother, so this is Cannon's mother. His mother posted on social media that she wanted as many people as possible to show up to the vigil to show love for Cannon. So if you're in that area, go and show up for the vigil. I want everyone to show up for my baby. If you love me and you have any heart or you love my child, please show up. Okay, so it's the funeral that's scheduled for tonight, Thursday night, and I believe the candlelight vigil is tomorrow. Hinnant's death has picked up coverage from various nationwide outlets, not as many as it should. The boy's family, friends, and city of Wilson, where he was from, have drawn sympathy from all over the country. There's also a GoFundMe page for his family. If you want to donate to that, I'll link it in the description below so you can find it there. That's basically what I have to say about that. It's really sad. He was a really cute little boy. Cannon Hinnant, 5 years old. That's who it was. Okay, thank you guys for watching.